In this video, we're going to be discussing aspect ratio. We will start by exploring its use as a creative tool with some visual examples, walk through a few of the technical details to understand the numbers, then wrap it up by reviewing some content on various display aspect ratios. Please note that if you're working on a Netflix production, all conversations about aspect ratio should begin with your Netflix creative team. Aspect ratio is simply the relationship between the width and height of any given rectangle. On the left, we have an aspect ratio of 1.78 to 1. This is the full screen display ratio of most TV and laptop screens. On the right, we have a widescreen 2.39 to 1 aspect ratio, which is the screen size generally associated with theatrical exhibition. When it comes to visual storytelling, aspect ratio is a powerful creative choice. As we view the images in the following slides, we won't be speaking to precisely what the director of photography was considering when choosing the frame size. Instead, we will focus on how aspect ratio choice can make us feel as a viewer. Aspect ratio can be helpful by establishing a mood or suggesting a particular genre or time period. It can be used when portraying characters by driving emotion based on their position in the frame and physical relationship to each other and their environment. Or it can be used to capture expansive scenery like sweeping landscapes or the height of an interior space, which can add to the feeling of realism. Let's look at how some common aspect ratios appear relative to one another on a single image. With the 1.78 to 1, the world feels tall, which makes the car feel smaller in the frame. The environment feels big with the ominous trees surrounding the vehicle, which communicates a specific mood to the viewer. As the ratio narrows down to 2.0 to 1, it starts feeling more cinematic as the perspective narrows, while making it feel a little less about the surrounding environment. Then with 2.39 to 1, we lose more of the canopy, which drives our focus to the car, making it feel more like the subject in the frame. Changing the vehicle's proportion to the surrounding environment adds horizontal weight, grounding us in the location with a heavy forest floor. This is an excellent example of having multiple characters in the frame. In 1.78 to 1, the focus would be drawn strongly to the relationship between the characters in the foreground, whereas widening out could provide space for the characters plus additional context as we see more of their environment. In a taller 1.78 to 1 framing, the cinematographer and director may choose to capture this scene in two different shots if intending to include the performance of the actor on the left, or they could position the actors into a single frame. Alternatively, with the wider 2.39 canvas, the story exists comfortably within a single frame, and the audience can engage by choosing who to watch. Either way, decisions around aspect ratio can impact the rhythm and pacing of how a story is told, and for the audience, add to the richness of the experience. Now, let's shift our focus to the more technical details about aspect ratios. Okay, what is aspect ratio? Let's quickly touch on the basics. It's just math, and it's not the scary kind. The pixel resolution of UHD is 3840 by 2160. So if we divide 3840 by 2160, this equals 1.78, and that is our aspect ratio based on the pixel resolution. The 1.78 to 1 aspect ratio seen on the left, also referred to as 16 by 9, quite literally means that it is 1.78 times wider than the height. On the right, the area within the red box is an example of a wider aspect ratio that is 2.39 times wider than the height, with the gray box representing how it would fit on a typical 1.78 TV. On a production, there are two different types of aspect ratios to consider. The container aspect ratio is the width and height of the file's container, including the mats, as seen here with the red box. When referring to original camera files, this is the full image area that the sensor is recording. A great example of container aspect ratio would be the final delivery to Netflix. This file's container is always in the form of UHD or HD, which has a container aspect ratio of 1.78 to 1. When the term active picture aspect ratio is used, we're referring to the image area within the container that's being framed for on set and ultimately delivered to the viewers at home. This would be the area within the red box that is excluding the mats. This is where the action happens. When there's a mismatch between the active picture aspect ratio and the display aspect ratio, you end up with black bars on the sides or top and bottom. When these black bars are on the sides, as seen on the left, this is referred to as a pillar box, whereas a picture with the black bars on the top and bottom is called a letterbox. Within the 1.78 delivery container, we can fit any active picture aspect ratio that's been deemed creatively appropriate for a title. When referring to wider aspect ratios, we're generally talking about those that have a narrower picture area within the full container. Within this UHD container, the aspect ratios with a number higher than 1.78 will be letterboxed, whereas a number lower than 1.78, as seen in the 1.33:1 picture on the top left, will be pillarboxed. So what does aspect ratio have to do with camera lens choice, whether that's spherical or anamorphic? While they can be associated with one another, like anamorphic and 2.39, they're not dependent on each other. You can capture with either lens type and crop to whatever active picture aspect ratio is ultimately best for the content. Some productions will choose multiple or dynamic aspect ratios for storytelling purposes. In these cases, there are certain technical considerations in picture finishing that are worth talking through. Please reach out to your Netflix creative team if your production is considering going down this path. Now that we've covered the basics of image aspect ratios, let's have a closer look at how they're represented on various displays. There are a multitude of display devices in the market today with a variety of screen aspect ratios. This means there isn't a one-size-fits-all solution when it comes to matching an aspect ratio to a specific viewing device. This slide illustrates exactly that. Four different aspect ratios on four different devices, all of which utilize most of the screen space. In the following few slides, we're going to have a look at the same aspect ratio on different consumer devices. In the upper left, we have a standard UHD or HD TV, which fills the screen entirely with the 1.78:1 content. The top right and bottom left are a couple of common phones featuring wider display aspect ratios. As you can see with this content, there will be some pillar boxing on the sides. Lastly, the tablet on the bottom right, which is often a taller device, results in a letterboxed image with the 1.78 content. Here we have 2.0:1 content, which is a middle ground between 1.78 and 2.39, and it's become a common choice for streaming content. It's a bit wider, so on a typical TV, there are black bars on the top and bottom, giving it some of that cinematic feel while also using a majority of the TV screen area. Pillar boxing on the phones has been reduced, so the image is occupying more of the screen. In this last example, this 2.39:1 image has more letterboxing on the TV and tablet, while it nearly fills the entire area of the phone's screens. As we can see, display devices have different aspect ratios, which impacts how the content fills the screens. For that reason, there's not one ideal creative aspect ratio suited for all devices. Aspect ratio choice should be based on what is best for telling the story. While aspect ratio is a creative decision, there are often related technical questions that may come up. Netflix is here to help. More video resources can be found on our YouTube channel. We also welcome you to visit the Netflix Partner Help Center to access a wide selection of guidance and best practices.